today. I know and trust that you had an awesome time celebrating the birthday of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And I know you took time out to worship Him, to celebrate the gift that God has given us, right? I know you did. So as always, get your Bibles, your phones, your tablets, so we can get into the Word of God that He has for us on this week. And what was our memory verse last week? Romans chapter 6, verse 23, talking about what God, the gift God has given us, the eternal life through His Son, Jesus Christ. I pray that you read that and meditate upon that scripture this week. And we're going to get right into our lesson and what God has for us on this week. And as you have your Bibles and whatever you have your Bible on, turn to James chapter 1, and I will begin praying. God, I come just to thank you for this day, Father. We thank you for this time that we're able to share in your word, God. We pray that your Holy Spirit will speak through me, God. Your word will be illuminated and give revelation to what you would have us to know on this day through your word, Father. I pray for all those who's listening in, your children, faith kids, that they, God, will learn of you and more about you and who you are in their lives, that they're able to apply what they have learned on today to their everyday situations, Father, that they will live a life that is pleasing unto you. In your Son, Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. All right, faith kids, we're going to be talking about on today, keep going and don't quit. Let's say that again. Keep going, don't quit. So in our lessons, we're going to be in James. So we're going to be talking about don't quit, keep going. What does that mean? So let's look in James chapter 1, and we'll start with our memory verse. Our memory verse is James chapter 1 and verse number 12. We'll just jump down to 12 and we'll come back to verse 12 again. So in verse 12, it reads, God blesses those who patiently endure testing and temptation. Afterwards, they will receive the crown of life that God has promised to those who love Him. In the King James Version, it says, blessed is the man who endures temptation, for having been proved, he shall receive the crown of life, which He has promised them that love Him. So we're talking about patiently endurance. We're talking about endurance, or we can say perseverance. And you're like, okay, Sister Angela, what does endurance or perseverance mean? Well, it's meaning that you're what? Keep going and don't quit. It means to persist, to remain constant when you're having a purpose or an idea or a goal or a task, that you continue to keep going and don't quit, no matter if you're in the face of obstacles or difficulties or whatever may come to you, think it's too hard. Oh, I can't do this. I don't know. It's stretching me. I'm like, I don't know. What should I do? What's the next step? But we're going to what? Keep going and don't quit in the face of trials when we're tempted. That's what the scripture is telling us, to keep going, to endure, to persevere, no matter what obstacles that was coming to discourage us or to, you know, take us like, no, you can't do it. Let's just stop. It's not going to work for me. No, God says that we're to persevere. We're to endure. We're to keep going and don't quit until we reach that goal or complete that task or to the finished work that He has given us to do. We are not to quit. We're to persevere and keep going. So faith kids, that's a word for you on today. Persevere, keep going, and don't quit. So let's go back up to James, and we're going to start with verse 2, reading verse 2, so we can just find out what God has for us in telling us that what we're to do. So in verse 2, it reads, dear brothers and sisters, when trouble comes your way, consider it an opportunity for great joy. It says that when we're tested, when we're tried, when we are tempted, when we go through trials or situations or whatever, that we like, oh, this is so hard. I don't know if I can do this. It says that when we go through those things, we are to count it or consider it as joy. We're to look at it as joy. And you'd be like, okay, if something is hard and I don't know, how can I look at it as joy? Because God says when we do that, it's an opportunity for us to just have joy and says, okay, I know this is hard. I know this may be difficult. I know it's like taking a little bit something from me to keep going and to keep doing this. But God says we can count it joy. We can look at it as joy because why? He's always with us. He said he never leaves us or nor forsake us. He is doing it to help us go through. So no matter what we're going through, no matter what test or trial, faith kids, God is always with us. And he says, just count it joy. Be happy going through it. Not happy because it's happening. That's not why you're happy. You're happy because you know that God is with you. And he, if you don't quit and you continue on, that you're going to get through it. Because he already said, even we talked about them in the boat and Jesus says, go to the other side. And they had a storm and they was like, we're in the storm, Jesus. Why are you telling us to go to the other side of the storm? Did not Jesus know it was going to be a storm? Yes. But he says, go to the other side. No matter the path that we get there, there may be a storm and some things that we go through. But we know that we're going to get to the other side. So this telling us that when we persevere, faith kids, keep going without quitting, we're going to get to the other side. We're going to get to that task or that goal that we're trying to reach. And how do we get there? Because God is with us and he's leading us and guiding and directing us. So you need to know, faith kids, no matter what seems hard, whether it's a test, maybe it's a, I don't know, a friend you're trying to have a friend with, maybe it's something your parents are asking you to do. Just know that you can do it because first he tells us we can do all things, what? Through Christ that strengthens us. So you're able to keep going if you, and just don't quit. I know sometimes we seem like, oh, I'm just going to stop. I don't need to do this. This is not for me. No, keep going. Keep going. Reach that goal and know that God is always with you. So let's continue to read on. In verse 3, it says, for you know that when your faith is tested, your endurance has a chance to grow. Did you hear what it says? It says when we're tested, when we're going through difficulties and it's too hard, it says you are being tested. But guess what? It says your endurance is tested and it has a chance to grow. So God is growing us. It's just like David with the lion and the bear. He fought what? Whichever one he fought first, he fought the bear and he did it. And so when the lion came, he was like, okay, I can look back on that because God brought me through this one. Oh, I can do this one too. And so we can do the same thing. When we don't give up and we keep going, faith kids, we can say, okay, I had a situation like this and I remember God did this for me and he helped me and I reached the goal and I passed that test or I ran the Olympics, whatever it is, he'll get me through this one too. So that's what we can do because that's why we count it all joy because we know that God is with us and we can be happy that, okay, it's a time for me to grow up, to go to the next level. I can't stay where I want to be because remember, God says we're going higher and higher from faith to faith and glory to glory. So he's not going to keep us at one level. But because of our faith, we keep growing in the things of God and he keeps taking us to another level because we can't have the same mindset because scripture says that we got to be transferred, faith kids. So he has to keep us growing. So how do you grow? Test. How do the teacher know that you know this material, that you learn what you need to learn? They give you a test. So why do the world give us tests and we think God doesn't give us tests, right? So that's how you know that you're growing. Because when you're tested, guess what? You pass the test. And you, not only you pass the test, you got God right there with you, going through it with you. So you pass the test. It helps you to grow. Let's keep reading. It's in verse number 4. So let it grow. For when our endurance is fully developed, you will be perfect and complete, wanting nothing. So it says that when we're going through these trials and we're growing and we're building up our faith, it says that we will be complete, wanting and lacking nothing, meaning God is putting into us those things that we need, that he knows that he has in us, and he's bringing them things out of us, faith kids, out of you, faith kids, that you can do it. And you're looking back like, I don't know how I did this. I don't know how, because what? God is with you and he's tested. He doesn't tempt us. He doesn't tempt us. But through the test, you will grow and God will bring you out. Let's continue reading. But when you ask him, be sure that your faith is in God alone. Do not waver, for a person with a divided loyalty is as unsettled as a wave of the sea that is blown and tossed by the wind. So it's saying that when we're going through these trials and we're being tested, we have to know that it's God who's with us. It's not ourselves. We have to know that it's God who's helping us and bringing us out of us. Sometimes because God has gifted us so well that we thinking, oh, I did this on my own ability and my own talent because I'm smart and I can do this. No, it's because God is with you. It's because who God has created you to be. So we can't forget that. And it says that if we do, we're like the wind. The water that and the wind blows. Have you ever been at the beach and you saw the waves and then the wind is blowing the waves and the waves is doing all this here? Yeah, it's blowing the water. That's what God says happens when we forget that it's him. When we're not trusting in him that he's with us and he's the one guiding us. He says we're like the water that the wind just keep blowing from here and tossing it to and fro. We're not stable. We're just going any kind of way. The wind and the water is just moving this way, moving that way, going backwards. But we're not like that because we're grounded and we're steadfast in God and in the things of God, knowing that he is always with us, right? So let's keep reading. And it says, such people should not expect to receive anything from the Lord. So when we're not grounded and trusting God that he's the one who's doing it and he's the one helping us, it says we don't need to expect to receive anything from God. Why should we expect to receive anything from God when we're saying we're not trusting in him, we're trusting in our own ability? But we know that we're trusting in God. It says their loyalty is divided between God and the world, and they are unstable in everything that they do. So when we start doing things the way the world do it and not how God say do it, then we're no longer on what he wants us to do. We're off his plan and his purpose that he has for our life. But as we're going through different things and we're doing things as God leading us, the Holy Spirit leads you, faith kids, you are able to do what God has called you to do. You're able to pass and go through and grow how God wants to do, that he's building up these things that he's already put inside of you so that you can know, I can do this. So when you come against different trials and tests in your life, no matter what, you'll know, okay, I can do it. I'm gonna stay in what God has told me to do. I'm not gonna quit. I'm gonna keep going. And I know that God will see me through this. Not in my own ability, not by myself, not because I'm good, not because I'm smart, but because it is God who helps me. And then he says he rewards us. He gives us a crown of life. He rewards us. So faith kids, what I want you to know from doing this lesson, that we're to keep going, that we're not to quit, we're to persevere. And how do we do that? First, we love God, because we can't do it without him. So we're loving God. And then we can seek him, ask him for his wisdom. God says, if you ask for my wisdom, I give it to you generously. He will give it to us. So we ask him for his wisdom to help us persevere, to help us go through, to help us not quit. And then not only that, when we're facing those trials and those difficulties, we keep in mind that God is with us. He's there to help us, leading and guiding and directing us along the way, faith kids. So remember, we got to what? Love God. We can ask him for wisdom. And when we're going through those difficulties, we can be assured he's with us. And then what? We receive rewards, right? When you get to the end of the thing, even if you're taking a test, you pass the test, you get your grade, you get your reward. So God will reward us when we're continuing to stay in him, not give in, persevere, keep going, don't quit, faith kids. I hope you have had a great message on today. Read your scripture, your memory verse, James 1:12, knowing that God is always with you and he wants you to persevere, to keep going, and not to quit, faith kids. Have a great week this week. I will see you next week. Have a blessed day.